also, for me, back in time, is this great song that I wrote for Kyla and I.
For me, it's taking me back to the music of 90s. It's that nostalgic feeling when my love for music really started. That's what back in time is for me. Why not? Because I love JR. He's a great friend, he's a great musician, he's a great singer, performer. I just cannot say no.
Still think I do. Boy, just take me away. I wanna go.
I think I I just have to be persistent, and I have to keep making music and keep getting better at writing and producing music, my original songs. And I think with my experience in the industry and creating these new songs and getting better and better, I think it will be somewhat of a pathway for me to get to the level I want to get to. I have so many upcoming projects that are always in motion, that are about to be done very soon, so I'm excited to present it to the world. One of them is my album that's coming out. We have 8 songs that's all ready, and it's ready for you, so please look out for that. But there's a lot more. There's a movie in the works, there's more albums under homeworks with other artists, and there's just always stuff. And the main thing is just to keep churning out music, keep getting artists that I believe in and keep supporting them, and just keep spreading good vibes and good music. Well, I've been performing live for quite some time now. I moved to the States during pandemic, and the States pandemic and Philippines pandemic are totally different. When we went to the States, it was pretty much opening up already. There was a lot of live shows happening, which was great for me because I was able to get in that circuit and perform live. And since then, it's been great because for 2 years, we've been locked up in the house, just singing on social media in front of digital crowds. But now it's an actual interaction with live people. I can see their faces, I can see their smiles, I can see them singing along and hear their voices, and it's totally different. That energy exchange is what I crave for on stage, and that's what we're getting, and that's what you're gonna get on September 2.
Oh, I wanna be wherever you are.
playing with my Barbie doll. Right? Nakatanggal yung ulo. I was already interested in singing. Kasi nag-audition ako sa choir in school. That's when my mom started grooming me, and she was my first teacher, teaching me how to sing properly. And then she enrolled me to this voice lesson. Nag-join ako ng a contest right away. On my 10th birthday, I auditioned for Pangalan ng Kampiyon. So, nung natanggap ako on my birthday, sobrang saya ko. Oh, wow! Parang, what a nice birthday gift. Ganyan. Tapos natalo ako. Minalat ako. Kasi, naghamugan. Totoo pala yun. So, on the day of the competition, umiyok ako. Kasi yung song ko was one moment in time. I got this call from somebody. It was Francis Guevara. He was looking for an R&B singer. And I do R&B. It's like my forte back in the day. In the 90s, R&B ganyan. But I'm gonna give it for a long time. It was one of the songs I submitted. It was for Metro Pop. But for some reason, he got that tape. And then he called up and then asked me if I wanted to do an album. It was an experiment. I got that break. And then that's when I recorded Hanggang Ngayon. So when finally I heard the song, grabe, talaga, I was so happy. And then I would request for my own song. As in, I would call the radio stations, because back in the day, you have to call and request for your song para masama siya sa top 10. And then I'd tell my dad, can you please, dad? My dad would call, my cousins would call, and then my classmates would call. Guys, kailangan mag-top 10 tayo. Call the radio stations. I have done 13 albums since the year 2000. Because that's when we released even Way to Your Heart, my first album. Usually, for the first few albums that we've done, all in all, producing and recording and mixing, it was in a span of 1 month. When we recorded that and we released it right away. Like I said earlier, it was really an experiment. We were not sure if ma-accept yung ako ng audience and my kind of music, if they will like it. But thank you, Lord. Nagustuhan naman nila. So I've done 12 more after that. So ganun lang yung creative process. It's usually very, very quick. The thing that takes more time, even looking for materials and songs. And then eventually, I started co-producing my albums, arranging, and being there with the mix na, and you know, in terms of like what instruments I want in the song, and the arrangement and the music. I tell the producer namin at that time, I'm excited about this concert, for sure. I've really been thinking about doing another album, because the last time we released one was 6-7 years ago. I miss it, so maybe I'll start writing songs again, maybe produce my own songs in my album, I'm not sure. And more collaborations, maybe with new artists. Sobrang saya, kasi parang 2 years and a half, parang forever yung feeling. And then finally, we're doing live shows again, we're gonna tour na ulit. Nakaka-inspire. You know, it's very inspiring na parang, you know what it's like, you know what it feels to not be doing this stuff, like live shows. And then suddenly, you're doing it again. Yung parang, mas na-cherish mo yung moment each and every time you're on stage. And I'm just very excited. For more to come, and this show, this concert, is very exciting.
Oh, Crazy about you. jumping above the clouds, the only way to fly is on the wings of love.
Yeah. Sing with me. through all this madness. Woman, don't you know with you I won't. Instead, with none.
Oh,
again I want to hear. Broke my faith in all these years. Late with you at night when I'm here all alone. Remembering when I was your own.
Even that I have for you. Thank you.